So hello everyone and welcome to another session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session, I will bring to you some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session and its link you will find in the description. You can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is about the Good Governance Index of 2021. Very, very important question. Definitely it will come in your exam. Chahe aap koi bhi exam dene jaoge agle aane wale 2-3 mahine mein, this question will definitely be there. Alright, so consider the following statements with respect to Good Governance Index 2021 and you have to identify the correct statement. So let's talk about the Good Governance Index and then we will come back to this question. So it was released by Union Home Minister and Minister of Cooperation, Mota Bhai Amit Shah, and it has been prepared by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. Do you remember this? It has been prepared by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances, and it is the second edition. It is the second edition. The first edition was launched in the year 2019. Pehla edition kab launch hua tha? 2019 mein. All right. Now it ranks states on the basis of 58 indicators divided into 10 sectors. Okay, total kitne indicators hai? 58 indicators hai. In the year 2019 there were 50 indicators, but now there are 58. Of course you don't have to remember the name of all the 58 indicators, and even ye number bhi yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai, that in which sector how many indicators are there. This is also not required for the exam. Just remember there are total 58 indicators divided into 10 sectors, and these are the 10 sectors: agriculture and allied sector, commerce and industry, HRD, public health, public infrastructure and utilities, economic governance, social welfare and development, judiciary and public safety, environment, citizen centric governance. And ye 10 bhi aapko yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. Just remember 58 districts and 58 indicators and 10 sectors. Okay, moving ahead. Now this index divides states into four categories. Char categories mein states divided hai. Number 1, northeastern hilly states. Number 2, union territories. Number 3, other states group A and other states group B. Theek hai? Do remember this categorization. This is important. The index categorizes states into four categories. Number 1 is the northeastern hilly states, union territory, other states group A and other states group B. Now here remember one thing, that Jammu and Kashmir is considered as a state in this index. Jammu and Kashmir ko state liya hai because as a UT sufficient data are not available for J&K and Ladakh. J&K aur Ladakh ke liye as a UT data available nahi hai, and that's why Jammu and Kashmir is considered as a state in this. Also Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu are considered as separate UTs. ठीक है, अभी हम सबको पता है कि ये दोनों मर्ज होके एक UT बन गए हैं. But in this index, Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu are considered as separate union territories. Again, because of the same reason, because merger के बाद का data sufficiently available नहीं है. Alright. Moving ahead to the rankings. Now remember, in the category of other states group A, Gujarat has topped the index followed by Maharashtra and Goa. Just remember the top 3. In the other states group B, Madhya Pradesh topped the index followed by Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh. In the case of northeastern and hilly state, it's Himachal Pradesh which is at number 1 followed by Mizoram and Uttarakhand. And in the case of UTs, Delhi has topped the index followed by Puducherry, and number 3 pe we have Daman and Diu. Okay, so this index mein itna hi padhna hai. There is no need to go into further details of this index. Baki aur sari sector wise ranking hai, wo padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Now let's come back to the question then. It has been prepared by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. This is absolutely correct. Its first edition was launched in 2020. No, the first edition was launched in the year 2019. Among the other states group A, Maharashtra has topped the index. It is not Maharashtra, it is Gujarat. Maharashtra is at number 2. And the index has 58 indicators. Yes, this is also correct. So वन एंड फोर इज करेक्ट. सो ऑप्शन सी ओनली वन एंड फोर गाइज विल बी दी करेक्ट आंसर बिकॉज सेकंड एंड थर्ड आर इनकरेक्ट एंड हियर वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दी करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इस वर्ड पे जरूर फोकस करा करो. कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि करेक्ट वाला और इनकरेक्ट वाला दोनों ही ऑप्शन गिवन होता है. ठीक है, तो इन दैट केस इस वर्ड पे हमें फोकस करना जरूरी होता है. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. नेम द रिसोर्स बुक ऑन वंदन योजना दैट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स हेडेड बाय मिस्टर अर्जुन मुंडा. अर्जुन मुंडा लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी इज खुंटी इन झारखंड. खुंटी इज द प्लेस वेयर द ग्रेट बिरसा मुंडा बॉर्न. सो नेम द रिसोर्स बुक ऑन वंदन योजना लॉन्च बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स. रिमेंबर द बुक इज ट्राइबल वंदन ट्राइफेड वंदन क्रॉनिकल. ट्राइफेड वंदन क्रॉनिकल इज द नेम ऑफ द बुक एंड रिमेंबर इट इज बेसिकली अ रिसोर्स बुक ऑन वंदन योजना एंड ट्राइफेड्स एक्टिविटीज अंडर द स्कीम. दिस बुक कंटेन्स ऑल द एक्टिविटीज दैट हैज बीन डन अंडर द स्कीम एंड वॉट हैज टू बी डन इन द फ्यूचर फॉर इफेक्टिव इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द स्कीम. अभी तक क्या हुआ है और आगे क्या करना चाहिए स्कीम को अच्छे से इंप्लीमेंट करने के लिए एवरीथिंग इज मेंशन इन दिस बुक विच इज नोन एज ट्राइफेड वंदन क्रॉनिकल. ओके एंड इट वॉज रिलीज बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स. डू रिमेंबर दिस. So therefore, the correct answer is what? Correct answer is what? As I told you already, Trifed Vandhan Chronicle. Trifed, remember, works under the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. It was established in the year 1987. And Mr. Ram Singh Radhwa. Ram Singh Radhwa is the chairperson of Trifed. Okay? Let's come to question number 3 then. With which of the following institutes, National Mission for Clean Ganga has launched first of its kind center of excellence on water reuse in New Delhi. First of all, do remember this, that this center of excellence on water reuse has been established in New Delhi. Where in New Delhi? In the office of the Energy and Resource Institute of India. The Energy and Resource Institute mein New Delhi ka jo office hai, wahan pe this center of excellence on water reuse has been established in collaboration with National Mission for Clean Ganga. So answer I hope आप सबको पता चल गया है. So it is the Energy and Resource Institute along with Directorate General of National Mission and of Clean Ganga. They both have jointly launched this Center of Excellence on water use. Now what is the objective of this center? So remember it will meet the objectives of Ganga Knowledge Center. It will meet the objectives of Ganga Knowledge Center, which is to foster research and innovation to make available treated water for reuse. ज्यादा से ज्यादा water जो है उसकी treatment हो और ज्यादा से ज्यादा पानी available हो for reuse. ये इसका focus है और इसके area में research and innovation को promote किया जाएगा through this center of excellence which has been established at the Energy and Resource Institute. Okay. So therefore the correct answer is what? TERI, the Energy and Resource Institute, option D. It was established in the year 1974 and remember, it is a non-profit research organization. It is a non-profit research organization and it is headquartered in New Delhi. So, iske headquarter mein hi ye center of excellence banaya gaya hai. Now, let's move ahead to question number 4. For which state government of India through Ministry of Ayush, headed by Sarbanand Sonowal, has released rupees 553.36 crore for various initiatives to push healthcare facilities in the state under National Ayush Mission. Very very important question. The exam mein pucha ja sakta hai that kaun se state ke liye diya hai. And of course this can also be asked that under which mission this amount has been given to Uttar Pradesh. The correct answer is what? Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh ko diya hai. So ye bhi pucha ja sakta hai ki under which mission this amount has been given. So in that case the answer would be National Ayush Mission, or you can say NAM. So let's talk about the news then. Ministry of Ayush has announced various initiatives to push healthcare facilities in Uttar Pradesh under National Ayush Mission. Now these are some of the initiatives that has been launched, and for this rupees 553.36 crore has been released by the government of India. Now, क्या क्या चीजें हैं? 8 आयुष इंटीग्रेटेड हॉस्पिटल्स विद 50 बेड्स इनॉग्रेटेड इन 8 सिटीज, 500 आयुष हेल्थ एंड वेलनेस सेंटर्स, आयुष एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट्स, 6 न्यू 50 बेडेड इंटीग्रेटेड आयुष हॉस्पिटल्स एंड 250 न्यू आयुष डिस्पेंसरीज टू कम अप इन डिफरेंट डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स. Now, these initiatives you do not have to remember. ये सारे याद रखने के लिए कोई जरूरत नहीं है. Just remember that under National Ayush Mission, the government of India has released 553.36 crore to improve the healthcare facilities in the state of Uttar Pradesh. That's it. ये एक sentence याद रख लो इस news में से. That is more than enough. All right. So therefore, the correct answer is what, guys? Uttar Pradesh. Option E, Uttar Pradesh is the correct answer. Recently, Atal Ekta Park was inaugurated in Jhansi in Uttar Pradesh during Rashtra Raksha Sampann Parv. I hope you remember this. Rashtra Raksha Sampann Parv was held in Jhansi, and during this event, Atal Ekta Park was inaugurated in Jhansi on the occasion of birth anniversary of Rani Lakshmibai. And Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh is the first Indian city to start ropeway services as the mode of transport. So Uttar Pradesh is the correct answer. Chief Minister, of course, is Yogi Adityanath. Question number 5. Which power PSU has signed a loan agreement worth $169.5 million with KfW, which is nothing but German Development Bank? Germany Development Bank hai ye. ठीक है, और KfW की फुल फॉर्म जर्मन में है, तो वो पढ़ने की कोशिश मत करना और याद रखने की भी कोशिश मत करना. टू फाइनेंस पावर एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी प्रोजेक्ट्स. नाउ इन दिस लोन वाला क्वेश्चन है, सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर विद विच बैंक दिस लोन हैज बीन साइन, किसने साइन किया है. ठीक है, तो इन दिस केस इट इज अ पावर PSU, एंड फॉर द पर्पज, फॉर व्हाट पर्पज दिस लोन हैज बीन टेकन. सो द पर्पज इज व्हाट? टू फाइनेंस द पावर प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड द रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी प्रोजेक्ट्स. So this power PSU, guys, is REC Limited. Option C, REC Limited, which is a Navratna company under the Ministry of Power, headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. Question number 6, again based on a loan. With which international bank government of India has signed a loan agreement worth 250 million euros for Agra Metro project? Again, very easy and very direct question. This bank is European Investment Bank, headquartered in Luxembourg. It is headquartered in Luxembourg. Do remember the headquarters of EIB. It can be asked in your phase 1 exam. So Luxembourg mein iska headquarter hai, and 250 million euros ka loan sign kiya hai government of India ne for Agra Metro project with European Investment Bank. So that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you tomorrow in the next session. Thank you so much. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.